Hello guys, I found this interesting fake downgrade. Now what's interesting about this one is that, well, it actually let me download the files and extract them, which is not normally what we let you do. It normally just asks you for a password. Now I did upload these to VirusTotal and it appears to be completely safe, however that could just be because this file has not been known by any antivirus yet. But yeah. A few things I noticed is that it says I want a junk file and it's used to anything. Now I can prove this, right? CSFlash.dll file. This is not actually a DLL file. If I open it with HXD, you'll see it has an FWS header. This is an Adobe Flash header. We'll see if I open up my Windows 10 folder and then go to my System32. I'll just go System32. Alright, and I scroll down a bit, and click on a random DLL file, and put that in here. You'll see it has an MZ header, which is expected for a DLL file. And that's not all, this phone also has got a firmware XXX file, which is some game's assets. If I look down here a bit, you can see some. I think I've discovered this was Silent Hill. Silent Hill. You see? And C:\wayforward, Silent Hill, blah blah blah. So this is some game files for Silent Hill. If we look in HXD, there's a eboot bin file here. This eboot bin is actually a legit eboot, as I noticed here and here. However, if we go right down to like the bottom and like scroll up a tiny bit, you'll see a reference to apt-0-se-module-steroid.suffix. Now this is the suffix file used by Hedeman in order to load DLC stuff, and so we have no has absolutely nothing to do with downgrading. In fact, this is just some random game dump that they took in the eboot bin out. Now, perhaps what's the most interesting is these files here. There's a whole bunch of font files, and then inside this PSP2 folder, there's a whole bunch of actually SWIFT files, so Shockwave Flash files. Now, this piqued my interest. I was like, okay, what the hell are these? So I've gone and downloaded Adobe Flash Player, and I'm gonna run a sandbox just to make sure it doesn't exploit anything or anything like that. Make it more secure. Alright, now I'll go open, browse. Going to go to these files, which are located on my 8GB partition, and read the downgrade, Flash, PSP2, a whole bunch of stuff here. I'm gonna go main, and just try and see what this is. So I'm gonna go main, and we're gonna see what we get. I see absolutely nothing here, so I'm gonna try a different one. How about help? Okay, I see a few things here, so I'm just gonna open up a few more of these and see what they are. How about zone select? There's nothing there either, so there's a bunch of random SWIFT files to do with something. Here's the nice gray screen. That one's got a nice view screen, okay. Well, anyway, perhaps the most interesting thing I'm going to be doing now is actually trying this out. So I'm going to run this sandbox, of course. Alright, so here we go, hit refresh. Nothing seems to happen, so I think I actually... Oh wait, would you look at that? I don't even have my Vita connected. My Vita is not even connected. I'm gonna hit the downgrade button and let's see what happens. My Vita is literally not even connected to the system and it's detecting it. That's not even my model number, that's not even its firmware. Right, I have my 3.65 Vita connected and it says PCH1008 even though it's a PCH2000. It says it's on 3.63, which is completely wrong. So this downgrade tool, Yitru just runs this thing. Always says it's the same thing. Always says it's on 3.63, even though it's actually on 3.65. Yeah, and I just unplugged it and it's still going, so tells me it's literally not even reading the USB input at all. I'm amazed that that worked. It's not even plugged in right now and it's still going. So let's try to see what happens. I'm gonna see if this drops any files on my system or anything like that. I'm running this in Sandboxy so I can check that sort of thing. This tool is completely fake. Now you say the wrong information, but there's literally no video even plugged in right now, and it's still progressing through the thing. Error code. So it gave us an error code. BSV.console and true again. Alright, so maybe it does actually need something connected. I'm gonna try clicking this refresh button again with nothing connected at all. So I'm just gonna close the program altogether and try running a sandbox. Alright, clicking refresh. Yeah, okay, Yitru just detected. So I think what he's done is he's just made it always throw an error no matter what. I'm not gonna bother trying to do it again. But yeah, anyway, that's so you've got this fake downgrade. I hope you all enjoyed that video. I think this one's pretty interesting. Thank you all for watching, goodbye.